إن الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما. اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد من على الأنبياء تقدم وكان أفصح العالمين منطقا إذا تكلم سيدنا ونبينا أبا القاسم محمد. اللهم يا ربنا زده شرفا وكرما وتعظيما وإجلالا وقدرا وصل وسلم وبارك عليه وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر. أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله أشهد أن محمد رسول الله أشهد أن محمد رسول الله. حي على الصلاة حي على الصلاة. حي على الفلاح حي على الفلاح. الله أكبر الله أكبر. لا إله إلا الله.
الحمد لله الحمد لله نستعينه ونستغفره ونستهديه ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا وسيئات أعمالنا. من يهدي الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له. الحمد لله رب العالمين والصلاة والسلام على أشرف المرسلين سيدنا ونبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. الحمد لله الذي شرفنا برمضان وأمرنا بصيامه وقيامه وأمرنا بصيام نهاره وقيام ليله. والحمد لله الذي شرفنا بالقرآن الكريم حيث أمرنا أن نقرأ القرآن ونتعظ ونتخذ منه دلالات على حياتنا. والحمد لله الذي شرفنا بنبيه رسول الله صلى الله تعالى عليه وعلى آله وأصحابه أجمعين وجعلنا من أمته عليه أفضل الصلاة والتسليم. ونشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له ولا مثيل له في علو شأنه وعظيم سلطانه. ونشهد أن سيدنا ومولانا محمدًا عبده وحبيبه ورسوله أرسله من أرجح العرب ميزانًا وأفصحها بيانًا فأوضح الطريقة ونصح الخليقة صلى الله تعالى عليه وعلى آله وأصحابه وأزواجه وأولاده وذريته وخلفائه المهديين من بعده ووزرائه العاملين في عهده خصوصا منهم على الأئمة خلفاء رسول الله على التحقيق أمراء المؤمنين حضرات أبي بكر وعمر وعثمان وعلي ذوي القدر الجلي وعلى بقية الصحابة والتابعين رضوان الله تعالى عليهم أجمعين. أيها المؤمنون الحاضرون اتقوا الله تعالى فيما أمر وانتهوا عما نهى عنه وزجر. O Muslims, believers, have taqwa. Taqwa is to show Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala obedience. As he said in Holy Quran, أطيعوا الله وأطيعوا الرسول وأولي الأمر منكم. Obey Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, obey Prophet, and obey those who are on authority, or those who are elderly than you, or those who are scholars. Obey them. If you obey Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, you are obeying Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam arsalahu Allah ta'ala rahmatan lil alamin. Allah sent him mercy for humanity in order to complete and perfect our manners. Prayers, fasting, zakat, hajj, tawheed, kalimatu shahada, all of them, they are instruments, if we can say instruments, or ways in order to polish our manners and our characters. As we are polishing, as it is necessary to polish the heart, it is necessary to polish also our behaviors toward each other. It is not enough to do your obligation, 5 obligations, and sit back. No. It's also to follow what Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, when he said, Jibril asked him about the level of ihsan, maqamul ihsan, the moral excellence, how to behave with each other, how a child behave with his father and mother, how the mother and father behave with that child. Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam used to call on Fatima and say to her, send me Al-Hasan wal-Husayn. They were young. Send them to me. Because what? Why Prophet asking her to send them? Because he wants to show love to her and to her children. He wants to show love that he has in his heart for these two children, Sayyidina Al-Hasan and Al-Husayn. He used to get them, when they come, they run to him, and he begin to smell them. And to begin with kissing them. Are you kissing your children? Are you giving them to feel happy emotions? Or are you boycotting them? You don't bother with them. Islam doesn't accept that. Islam wants from the father and mother to show their children love. Because Allah said, if you really love Allah, follow Muhammad. وَمَا أَتَاكُمُ الرَّسُولُ فَخُذُوهُ. Whatever Prophet gave to you, follow. And Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam showed us how much he loves his grandchildren. And when Sayyidina al-Hasan or Sayyidina al-Husayn, when he is praying and jump on his back, he doesn't come from sajda until they step down. He keep in sajda until they get bored, they don't want anymore to sit on his back, they go down, then he come up from sajda. Or else he will keep making sajda, even if it is 1 hour, he is in 1 hour making sajda until they go out from his back. I'm seeing too many children are being left for on their own without a guidance. You are responsible for guiding your children. And the children are responsible to react well to their parents, especially to their father. Especially who the one who raised them and worked hard in order to prepare for them a bite to eat. The mother doesn't work. She raised them at home. Her work is to raise the children, Islamically. But now today, everyone is working because situation is changing, and they say it's not enough for one person to work. We need 2 persons to work. It's up to them. But what we want to say is that the father is running from morning to evening to provide his wife, to provide every child of his children. So the responsibility also, there is a responsibility on the children. Allah said, وَلَا تَقُلْ لَهُمَا أُفٍّ وَلَا تَنْهَرْهُمَا وَقُلْ لَهُمَا قَوْلًا كَرِيمًا. If your father or your mother call upon you or ask you something to do, don't say oof. He said, وَلَا تَقُلْ لَهُمَا أُفٍّ. Don't say oof. Don't answer them. Keep quiet. Like in army, can you answer the general? The house has a general, the father and the mother. وَقَضَى رَبُّكَ أَنْ لَا تَعْبُدُوا إِلَّا إِيَّهِ وَبِالْوَالِدَيْنِ إِحْسَانًا. He put ibadah together with to be muhsin to your parents. وَبِالْوَالِدَيْنِ إِحْسَانًا. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, وَقَضَى رَبُّكَ أَنْ لَا تَعْبُدَ إِلَّا إِلَّهِ لا تعبدوا إلا إياه. Allah said, don't worship other than him. وَبِالْوَالِدَيْنِ, and for the parents to show them good manners, not to answer them, not to come against them, not to say to your parents, oof, what is this? You are old-fashioned. If the father is reading Quran, or what you are reading, as you are old-fashioned. You read a drama book, a fiction book, it's better for you. History book. People are running, shaitan is playing with us. And we are in Ramadan. So the best of children are the best who listen to their parents and obey them. And the best of parents is to look after their children and show them love and hinniya and softness, not to be hard, not to be rude. You don't smile, you are so serious, as if there is in front of you something, a lion wants to eat you. Both sides, they have to show, the children has to show respect to their parents, and the parents has to show love to their children. In Ramadan, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the month of the ummah. Allah dress everyone who is fasting with his rahmah. First 10 days, which have already been passed, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala dressed every one of us, every mu'min, every Muslim who is fasting, especially in Ramadan. It's not in any other month else, only in Ramadan. أَوَّلُهُ رَحْمَةٌ. The first 10 days, Allah dressed you with His mercy. And who is the rahmah? Rahma is al-Rahma al-Muhdat. The gifted Rahma to the Ummah is Sayyidina Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Means he asked his Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, if we did something wrong, to intercede immediately according to the hadith, strong hadith, sahih hadith, تُعْرَضُ عَلَيَّ أَعْمَالِ أُمَّتِي. I observe the amal of my Ummah. By Allah's order, Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, in his life, in his grave, in the day of judgment, he observed the amal of the ummah. Allah gave him that. تُعْرَضُ عَلَيَّ أَعْمَالُ أُمَّتِي. The first 10 days, the amal of mu'mins and Muslims are being observed by Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, by Allah's power. فَإِنْ وَجَدْتُ خَيْرًا حَمَدْتُ اللَّهِ. Prophet is saying, if I see good, I thank him, I praise him, I glorify him, I glorify Allah, I praise Allah, I thank Allah that that abd is good. He will be dressed immediately with this mercy. Hamadullah. Prophet is thanking Allah on behalf of that servant that he did well in the first 10 days. وأوسطه مغفرة. And the middle of it, the middle 10 days is forgiveness. To those who are fasting, those who are showing respect, those who are showing love to their children, those children are showing love to their parents, you are prohibiting yourself from eating, from drinking, from backbiting, from fitna, from everything that Allah doesn't like, you are prohibiting yourself from it. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Prophet saying that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will give us maghfirah. That is the continuation of the hadith of Prophet where he say, تُعْرَضُ عَلَيَّ أَعْمَالُ أُمَّتِي فَإِنْ رَأَيْتُ خَيْرًا حَمَدْتُ اللَّهِ. If I see good, I observe the amal. He's observing. If he see good, alhamdulillah. If he didn't see good, فَإِنْ وَجَدْتُ خَيْرَ ذَلِكَ. If I found something different, استغفرتُ لَهُ. I will ask forgiveness on their behalf. Means, in that first 10 days, Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam is preparing us to dress, to be dressed with rahmatullah. Second 10 days, he is asking on our behalf forgiveness. If we did something wrong, of course everyone can do something wrong at any moment. No one is ma'soom, infallible. All of us, we make sins, and you don't know what kind of sin Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala ordered the angel. Even it is a small sin, we don't know. It's small from big. You might, today, even the sins coming to your home by these internet and computers and televisions, everywhere you look, there is a sin. Shaitan brought it, and they say technology, modernity. What kind of modernity and technology that takes us to hellfire? So Ramadan Allah gave to us in order to be forgiven. So second 10 days, which we are in it now, Prophet is observing by Allah's order. If there is something wrong, he will ask Allah on our behalf forgiveness. But we have to struggle. We have to show that we are doing something. So the third 10 days, when Allah dressed you with His mercy, first 10 days. Second 10 days, He forgave you from your sins. The third 10 days, it is atkum min an-nar. It's free from hellfire. Means Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, as Prophet mentioned, Allah will forgive. Allah will mercy the first 10 days, forgive the second 10 days, the third 10 days free you from any question in the day of judgment directly to paradise for those people who are fasting. So what is our job then? Is to thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And to find those who are elder than us, those who are more educated, more enlightened, more dressed with knowledge, because we need guidance. No one can say, I guide myself. You know, even in the car today, you put GPS to guide you. For travel into this religion, this deen, you don't need a guide. You need a guide. You need someone to show you the way. Why today you see children, they gather around one person to show them the way? Either a good person, he will take them to good places like masajid, or a bad person who takes them to gangs. to do something wrong. Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, "In kuntum thalatha fa'ammiru ahadakum." If you were three, don't be everyone with his opinion. Put one amir on you. One responsible. Don't say, "I don't need," then you are objecting on the hadith of Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Today too many people, they said, "Oh, we don't need guidance, we guide ourselves." Where you want to guide yourself? Look in Middle East countries, they guiding themselves, they are killing each other in their demonstrations. What is the benefit of demonstration in the streets? You don't believe in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, go to the mosque and pray and ask Allah, "Duni astajib lakum." Allah will change for you. Allah will not send you on you zulma, darkness, or to be oppressed by others. Those whom Allah knows their heart are good will be guided. لا تهدي من أحببت إن الله يهدي من يشاء. Don't guide whom you like, Allah guides whom He likes. And this month is the month of guidance. Everyone, Allah guiding him, look at Makkah al-Mukarramah or Medina al-Munawwara. Who is sending these millions of people? Who guided them? A scholar? Alim? Anyone? Why they are running toward Makkah for Umrah? Why they are running toward Medina for Ziyarah? Because in Mecca there is the house of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. In Medina there is the Prophet of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So if someone guide you toward Mecca, go with him. Because that guidance is coming from heavens. No one will enter Mecca and Medina without permission by heaven. Don't think people are going by themselves. No. When the permission comes, because these are two sacred places. And the third sacred place is Masjid al-Aqsa. Inshallah, it will open soon. Who will guide you? Millions and millions of people. Every moment, their people are doing tawaf. Allahu Akbar. Allahu Akbar. والعزة لله ولرسوله وللمؤمنين. What a religion Allah gave to us. What a religion Allah brought us in. You have to be happy. الكبرياء لله. But we are proud. We can say this in accepting, in being in Islam. We are proud that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala dressed us from Islam, Nur al-Iman, Nur al-Islam, without any work from ourselves. So the last 10 days is عتكم من النار. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is forgiving, is freeing us from hellfire. Look for a guide in your heart. Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, إِذَا أَحَبَّ اللَّهُ عَبْدًا جَعَلَ لَهُ وَاعِظًا مِنْ قَلْبِهِ. If Allah loves one person, loves an individual, anyone. If you show Allah loves love, Allah shows you love. مَنْ تَقَدَّمَ إِلَيَّ شِبْرًا تَقَدَّمْتُ إِلَيْهِ بَاعًا. Who approached me one hand, I approached him one arm. So Allah waiting for us to come and say, "Ya Rabbi, we are coming to you. Open your door for us," saying, "La ilaha illallah Muhammadur Rasulullah." Come to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He is the one that will dress you with his maghfirah. Not anyone else. Prophet will intercede, yes. Allah will give him shafa'ah. مَنْ ذَا الَّذِي يَشْفَعُ عِنْدَهُ إِلَّا بِإِذْنِهِ. Allah will give shafa'ah to Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam in day of judgment to for his ummah. But what we have to do? Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, "Man la yashkuru Allah, la yashkuru an-nas." He said, عن أبي هريرة رضي الله تعالى عنه وأرضاه قال قال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم لا يشكر الله من لا يشكر الناس. He said that you are not considering, you are not considered thanking Allah if you don't thank the people for whatever they did for you from ma'roof. Whatever they did for you from favor, you have to thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You have to thank those people who gave you that. So we have to thank Allah day and night. Not one time and we stop. But daily, you're eating, you say, Shukran ya Rabbi, Alhamdulillah. Drinking, Alhamdulillah, Shukran lillah. Wearing clothes, Allah gave you clothes, Shukran ya Rabbi. Electricity, Shukran ya Rabbi. Look, in the old time, they used to read or sit together on the lamp, oil lamp, or on candle. Today you don't bother with that. You push a plug and the electricity is there. We thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. أفضل الأمة أخير الأمة آخر الأمة. The best of the most favorable ummah is ummah of Rasul sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Afdalul ummah, akhirul ummah, akhirul ummah. The best of the ummah is those who came after Sahaba, and first century, second century, third century of Prophet, and then those who are coming at the end of time. Don't say we are still. This still life is going to be thousands and thousands of years. No, Prophet was preparing Sahaba as if tomorrow is going to be last day. اقتربت الساعة وانشق القمر. Prophet, from that time Allah said in Holy Quran, the time approached for the day of resurrection, when the moon split between the hand of Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. O mu'min, we are in the middle of the middle 10 days. It is the days of maghfirah. Try as much as we can to ask Allah forgiveness. وَمِنَ اللَّهِ التَّوْفِيقِ أَقُولُ قَوْلِي هَذَا وَأَسْتَغْفِرُ اللَّهَ الْعَظِيمُ لِي وَلَكُمْ وَلِسَائِرِ الْمُسْتَغْفِرِينَ فَيَا فَوْزًا لِلْمُسْتَغْفِرِينَ أَسْتَغْفِرُ اللَّهَ. الحمد لله حمد الكاملين والصلاة والسلام على أشرف المرسلين سيدنا ونبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. تعظيما لنبيه وتكريما لفخامة شأن صفيه، فقال عز وجل من قائل مخبرا وآمرا: إن الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي، يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما. اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد الناهي أمته عن دار الجحيم، مفخر العرب والعجم، مولانا ومولى العالمين المحترمين سيدنا أبي القاسم محمد. يا أيها المشتاقون نور جماله والمحتاجون شفاعته، صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما. اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد وعلى آل سيدنا محمد، كما صليت على سيدنا إبراهيم وعلى آل سيدنا إبراهيم في العالمين إنك حميد مجيد. وبارك اللهم على سيدنا محمد وعلى آل سيدنا محمد، كما باركت على سيدنا إبراهيم وعلى آل سيدنا إبراهيم في العالمين إنك حميد مجيد. اللهم اغفر للمؤمنين والمؤمنات والمسلمين والمسلمات، الأحياء منهم والأموات، واغفر لنا ولإخواننا الذين سبقونا بالإيمان، ولا تجعل في قلوبنا غلا للذين آمنوا، ربنا إنك رؤوف رحيم يا أرحم الراحمين. اللهم انصر المجاهدين في مشارق الأرض ومغاربها. اللهم أعز الإسلام يا ربي يا الله، وأعز كلمة هذا الدين. إنك على كل شيء قدير وبالإجابة جدير. وصلى الله على سيدنا ونبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. سبحان ربك رب العزة عما يصفون، سلام على المرسلين، والحمد لله رب العالمين. إن الله يأمر بالعدل والإحسان وإيتاء ذي القربى وينهى عن الفحشاء والمنكر والبغي يعظكم لعلكم تذكرون. ولذكر الله أكبر، والله يعلم ما تصنعون. أقم الصلاة.